in high school that remember synthesizing a compound, chromium, ACAC, and just fell in love with the whole process and making things and the rules of chemistry and understanding how you could use that to make molecules. I think it's important for young people to explore what they like and what they don't like and what they're good at and what they're not good at in a safe environment. And it's neat when people know early in their lives what they want to do, but it's also important for people to experience a lot of different things and find out what they're not great at or what they don't like. And what I love about science is you can do so many things, like in this, my career and what I've done is almost episodic and be able to completely turn a page on a topic and move into new topics is really interesting. I enjoy that, diversity. And you know, it's really interesting, if you think about innovation and what drives innovation, you realize it quickly that diversity is a fundamental tenet of innovation. You know, it's mathematically substantiated. And you know, I've been part of a lot of different design teams in my career with a lot of young people, and I could tell you, I can see the difference between how somebody grew up with not much money thinks about problem-solving differently than somebody grew up with a lot of money. And you want that richness to come together. And you have to, you know, think about almost engineering your community to foster innovation. School science and math has paid attention to this, the faculty, the students. And so that fosters a foundation for innovation that's really, really critical, and it's an important part of the school. I love folks that love science and love to think big. And I've always found that perspective coming from the students in science and math. And you know, they're not there to do incremental things. It just feels like they're there to change the world. And I love the esprit de corps with people that are thinking about they can make a difference.